Hello, my little champs. You all are welcome to our English class. This is me, Farhat Hussain, your English teacher. Children, I have some questions which I want to ask from you. Okay? Then, my first question is, what do you call to your mama and papa? Then you will tell, mom, it is so easy. And that is parents. Right. Now tell me, what do you call to the parents of your parents? Then again you will say, mom, it is also so easy. And that is grandparents. Right. So children, today we are going to recite a poem whose title is Grandparents. Now, at first we will come to know what is poem. Then, a poem is a beautiful ray of enjoying words in a rhyme and rhythm. Okay? Now, we will come to know what is the meaning of this word grandparents. Fine? So, the word grandparents means Nana Nani and Dada Dadi. Children, when we hear this word grandparents, then we can immediately feel love, care, affection and kindness. Okay? Because they hold very special place in our heart. We love the company of our grandparents because they shower their love on us and they used to tell some interesting stories which we like the most. And one more thing is that they make us so special in our family. हम चाहे कितने भी बड़े हो जाए बट वो हमेशा हमें इतना छोटू सा समझते हैं, है ना? समझते हैं ना? सो चिल्ड्रन, लेट्स मूव टू द पोएम. ओके, आई एम गोइंग टू रिसाइट दिस पोएम, ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स पोएम 2. फ्यू कैन ब्रिंग द वार्मथ वी कैन फाइंड इन देयर एम्ब्रेस, लव एंड केयर इज नीडेड टू ब्रिंग अ स्माइल ऑन देयर फेस. दे आर अ स्टोर हाउस ऑफ स्टोरीज and they have time to wipe our tears. They make us laugh and smile and grow precious through the years. I believe that God sent us grandparents as our present from above to share the moments of our life as a symbol of God's love. By Anonymous. See children, here the word Anonymous means an unknown poet. In this poem, Anonymous means a known poet, and if there will be a story, then there will be a known writer or author. Okay, fine. It means what? We don't know who has written this poem. Now let's move to the new words. First one is your warmth, means feeling of love. Embrace means hug. A storehouse, a place where we keep things to use when needed. Wipe, dry with a cloth or one's hand. Precious, of great value, means expensive. You can say moments, a short period of time. Symbol, something that stands for another thing. Okay, now children, let's move to the poem. See children, there are so many rhyming words are there in this poem, and in each stanza there are two rhyming words. Okay, there are two rhyming words. See, and now you will ask, ma'am, what is a stanza? Then a paragraph in the poem is known as a stanza. Okay, if there will be paragraph in a story, then that will be called as paragraph, but in poem it will be called as stanza. Okay, and in this poem there are three stanza. Okay, first one is, you can see, and each stanza contains four lines. Fine, there are four lines in each stanza and two rhyming words in it, each stanza. Now we will come to know what are those rhyming words. See, in the first stanza, embrace, face, these are rhyming words, they are sounding the same, isn't it? Embrace, face. Come to the second stanza, tears, ears. In the third stanza, above, love. Got it? Now I'm going to explain the poem. Okay, coming to the first stanza, see, I will explain each stanza one by one. Come to the first stanza, few can bring the warmth we can find in their embrace, love and care is needed to bring a smile on their face. Now children, coming to its explanation, see, only few persons are there who give us love, affection, care and kindness. And our grandparents are one of them who give us love. Okay? They shower their unconditional love on us and they make us feel so special. When we hug them, then we can feel all this love, care, affection. And children, when the time passes, we become grown-ups, but our grandparents become old. And at this stage, they need love and care from us. Okay? And if we do so, then they feel so happy. And this is the way through which we can bring a smile on their face. Now children, coming to the second stanza, see, they are a storehouse of stories and they have time to wipe our tears. They make us laugh and smile and grow precious through the years. Now coming to its explanation, children, as we all know that we love to hear stories from our grandparents, hai na? And you know what? Our grandparents used to tell us every day a new story. Their stories can never be finished. So they are called as storehouse of stories. What are they called as? They are called as storehouse of what? Stories. Grandparents are such persons who are always available and ready to make us happy and to wipe our tears when we are sad or we are in pain. Then they will be always available and they will be always ready to wipe our tears. Okay? And they make us feel so special. And this is because they always want to see us happy. As we grow up, then we come to realize the importance of our grandparents and their contribution in our life. And then we come to know that how much they are precious for us. As the time passes, then we come to know how much they are precious for us, how much they mean for us. Now children, coming to the third stanza, see, I'm going to recite it. I believe that God sent us grandparents as our present from above to share the moments of our life as a symbol of God's love. And children, here the poet says that God has given us blessings and gifts in the form of our grandparents. Okay, as we all know that God loves us, but he can't be present with us physically, hai na? So children, God has sent our grandparents so that he can shower his love on us. His love means what? God's love. Okay, hence grandparents are the representative of God, and hence they are considered as symbol of God's love. Whose love? God's love. So children, this was your poem about grandparents, and I'm sure you will also love and care your grandparents. So that's all for today, and now it's time to say you goodbye and thank you.